Hello and welcome to HBFT Gaming. I'm HBFT and we are taking our very first look at Among Trees. Among Trees is a beautifully lit and aesthetically striking game in the survival genre. And I gotta say, the moment I saw the screenshots and a bit of the trailer for it, it instantly reminded me of my time in Firewatch, which is one of my favorite games that I've ever played, so much so, in fact, that we've actually decorated our bedroom like Firewatch. So, no, that's very, very true. So while the survival genre isn't my normal cup of tea, I just couldn't resist the peaceful, almost tranquil nature of the visuals, and I thought that it would be awesome to check it out together. All right, here we are, buddies. Let's go ahead and check this out. Brand new game. Okay, there are two modes. Standard, there are a few dangerous animals. For the best all-around gaming experience, no dangerous animals if you don't deal well with tingling bear encounters. This mode is for you. You know what? We're going to go with standard. I think we'll be okay, even though this isn't our regular game style. Normal, you'll have to look for food sometimes, but there's still plenty to go around. I'm on it. This is our first time in, so let's take a look. And I do want to remind people that this is the pre-alpha footage. So this is in early access currently available on the Epic Games launcher and the Epic Games store. So if you'd like to check it out, you'd have to go to Epic Games, but it is going to be available on Steam in the future. I mean, come on. Look at this game. It's so freaking pretty. Wow. All right, I just realized that my camera is currently covering up some of the buttons on the lower left. So let me just go ahead and pause for a second and I'll adjust that. All right, we are back. So hopefully you can see a little bit more. It looks like we've got our hands equipped right now. Never thought I'd have to equip my hands. Fur plank. Looks like we're going to be gathering some resources. Press tab to open your backpack. All right. Fur plank. These beautiful planks smell of the fur they were cut from and are durable, flexible, and rot resistant. Use them to repair and expand your cabin. All right, we're already at the point where we can have a cabin. What's this? I'm assuming this is our hunger. And is this our... Oh, look at us! Norette lumber outfit. It pretty much just gives us human decency. It doesn't actually have any other benefits to it. Very, very low. All right, more planks. I think it would be really strange to walk around the woods and then find out that they're just random planks just kind of chilling, don't you think? God, it's so freaking beautiful. I'm assuming things have to glow to grab it, right? Some sticks, all right. Golden chanterelle. Dude, chanterelle mushrooms are so good in food, especially sauces. All right, so we've gathered quite a number of sticks. I know they mentioned that the fur planks are really good with our cabin. Oh, there we go. That looks like our cabin. Perfect. We're just using our hands. Everything's good. Definitely a humble start for sure, but if we can use our planks, I'm sure we can make this better. Fur planks and sticks. Ah, okay. Note items. Oh, look at that. That's such a nice interface. It sets it up like a quest on the right. All right. Let's see. We need more sticks. I see some sticks back there. If we hold shift, you can sprint, but you do have stamina that you have to be concerned with, it looks like. Oh! Gosh, that was like a magenta bird or something. Everything's so vivid. Let's see. We need more planks, right? I'm assuming... Can we, like, punch things? I'm hitting the mouse button. Doesn't really seem to do anything, so I can't really, like... I remember some other games that I played... You can kind of punch logs and things, and it reduces the durability, and eventually you can grab and just kind of break off pieces of it, like bark and the like, and then you could pick that up. But in this case, it doesn't look like... I mean, that's probably more realistic. It doesn't look like you can do that. Ruby beets, probably want to eat those. All right, so we have enough sticks now. We need two more planks. We could venture farther out. Seems like... I'm really curious how planks would just fall off of trees in plank form, unless we can create planks, maybe? Out of branches or sticks or something like that. Oh, look at the lighting. Oh my god. Oh, I freaking love it. All right, more mushrooms. Oh. Look at the rub. Look at the bunny. I saw a bunny. Look at that. Oh my god. Adorable. So I'm curious. I bet those planks are things that you normally have to create, but they kind of toss some planks at your feet early in the very beginning, in the beginning area around the cabin. So I'm going to try and stick there. There's a hare. So cute. Hi. You disappeared into a rock. Oh my god. Can you imagine playing this in VR? Oh, that would trip me out. Be freaking gorgeous. It's so relaxing. I mean, I know that the difficulty setting said that if you find a bear, that's probably not going to be very relaxing, but dear god. There's got to be more planks around here, right? There it is. There we go. All right, 5 and 6. Excellent. We have everything that we need now. We're all in the green on the right there. Hey, it looks like we're getting a little bit hungry. So let's hit tab. We'll take a look at these beets. Okay, so you can see right here in this really, really nice interface that this will fill up our, if cooked, cannot be eaten raw, but if we cook it, it will definitely help our hunger by quite a lot. Raw, a little bit. What is this? Is this like toxicity or something? Cooked? I don't know what this is. Huh. We'll have to figure that out. Eating it raw will sate your hunger and improve your health, but cooking it will bring about a miraculous full recovery. All right, we'll just eat a little bit. So I guess that's our health, the little keyhole. All right, bunnies. Cabin features unlocked. Sleep. Get a good night's sleep in the bed. Save your progress. Oh, nice. Definitely like saving storage. Put things you don't need at the moment in the storage box. Holy god. It's so cute. Hi. Oh, we even have a book? No way. All right, we just saved. Beautiful. Crafting room. More planks. Steel wire. Stump moss. To make a crafting room. Gosh, to find so many planks, that's tough. Storage attic. Oh, gosh. How are we doing? Oh, we've got a box, though. So that should be okay. And we've got a cooking room. Cooking's going to be important. Let's do that immediately. I don't know where we're going to find bolts, though. Huh. All right, well, let's just start collecting things. It seems like planks are the kind of the common denominator between all of these recipes. So we got to keep an eye out for planks. I would love it if we can graduate from eating raw items to cooked items, because it seems to unlock the improved benefits there. A hoof fungus. Actually, how would we build a tool? Is there any place other than the crafting room where we can build things? And the backpack slot 12. Oh, okay. So that gives us these 12 slots here, 3x4. Restack them. Oh, that's cool. And we do have a storage box inside of our cabin. Let's see. Planks. We don't have a compass, so I'm going to just head in a straight line from this side of the cabin and see what we encounter. I know that we ran into some hares. I don't think we can catch them with our bare hands. Definitely when we were sprinting, it seemed like we could never really catch them, which I guess is pretty realistic. I wonder if I'm going to... So when you're in the woods... Oh, look at that. Does that count as a plank? That's like a whole branch. And we got beets. So when you're in the woods, crossing a river is very, very dangerous. So I'm going to go ahead and face upwards. I don't know if anything happens to me. Face upstream. Curious about... If you look in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, you're going to see... Kind of looks like the sun is going down. I think that's what that icon means. Oh, and there are bees. I don't want to get close to that. Although it's good to know that if we leave to the right, if we face the front of the cabin, I'll just call this east because I don't know which way it is yet. We should probably go back, right? Because it's dark. If you go east from the cabin, that will run into that. But I don't know if that's a good idea to get stung since this is a survival game, right? So let's head on back. We'll take a quick rest. We'll see how we get on. It seems like we're okay crossing this with no ill side effects. At the very least, we're not hungry. Mulberries. I wonder if those were growing. Because I don't remember seeing that before. That's cool. And it's very user-friendly. You can see that the cabin is always available on the HUD. I've seen some other games where they take the survival aspect, like, more... I guess more critic... Is it more critically? I don't really want to say seriously, because every game kind of has its own tone, and this one seems to be almost meditative in nature, which is beautiful. And you can see my stamina is dangerously, dangerously low. And it only comes up to a certain amount. See? Previously, my stamina was all the way full. This seems to recover... Does it go all the way up? Does it go all the way up? Is it because we're near the cabin? Oh, it did go all the way up. Never mind. We'll tell you what. Let's go ahead and save. And we'll sleep because it's getting dark. And let's pay attention. Pay attention to the right, the lower right of the screen so you can see all the Z's. Day number 2. Oh, it's counting down. Okay, and as you see in the upper right-hand corner, that's really, really cool. The little sun is going up now. So let's go ahead and start by eating our breakfast. We're going to have some button mushrooms, some raw ones. Perfect. We're all topped off. So if we head, let's head towards the sun. You know, a lot of power on Earth comes from the sun. Tesla is run by the sun. So we'll head towards the sun and we'll see how this goes. And then when we come on home, we'll be heading towards the sun again, which I think is quite poetic, really. Always follow the sun. And you'll get to where you need to go. I don't know if that's true, but... Alright, we got some sticks. Oh, we got a lot of sticks. I wish we could build something out of sticks. Can we build a fire? Dude, that would be great. Can we craft a fire? I remember when I was hiking, I carried a little... I forget what it was called. It was like a hobo stove, kind of, if that makes any sense. It was like a metal can. And it had portholes, and it had an inner layer and an outer layer, and it had an aluminum bottom. So what you would do is you would pick up any sticks, things like this, and then just toss it in the middle, and it burned really, really, really cleanly. And the great thing is, so you didn't really have to clear out any debris. Wow, this is deep. Can I swim? Can I swim? Okay, I can swim. Wow, I'm gonna swim towards the sun. Seems a bit dangerous. I doubt there are sharks here, but but it's a video game, you never know. Oh my god. We're freezing. Oh, our temper, that's temperature, not health. Oh boy, so eating chanterelles will help our temperature. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, we made a mistake. What happens when we're freezing? Does our heart go down? Whoa. We're slowing. Oh wow, we're slowing down. Uh-oh. So what's going down now? Our health, our heart. Okay, so that's temperature. Let's get out. Come on, get out. Oh, I can't jump. Come on. Uh-oh. What have I done? Are we gonna die already in this peaceful, peaceful game? Come on. Okay, we have to get all the way over here. Maybe we go around next time. Oh, look at that bunny. Oh, thank God. Okay, so to raise our temperature, I guess it makes sense you eat a little bit, but this is kind of an emergency, so let's raise our temperature a little bit. I wonder why eating chanterelles raises our temperature. I remember at one point when I was hiking, there was a time when it was, I think it was like 4 in the morning. I got up really early because I needed to make a lot of distance. And I ended up at the bottom of, I want to really call it a ravine, but, and it's not really a valley either. It was just... There were high, like 12 switchbacks on both sides, like 800 feet up or so. And I was at the very bottom of it. And it was so dark that if I stepped incorrectly, I would literally fall off of a really sharp drop. So I remember I just sat down on a rock, which was super cold. And all of a sudden, and this is where I'm getting back to the game, I ended up eating a Clif Bar, one of those with filled with peanut butter. And I just felt the heat rush from where I was eating. And I could almost mentally trace where all of the food was going in my body. Or at least I imagined it so. And I would imagine that if you're eating these chanterelles, maybe it's something similar. Like it raises your temperature. I could feel my body generating heat. It was like calories were instantly transformed into usable energy. Still haven't found planks. I heard some bees earlier, and we are headed towards the sun, and the sun's still coming up. Our temperature's back up. What is this? Oh, a box? Oh, an attack. What is this? I need an axe. I don't know how to make an axe. Can I fit a rock to this? Okay, so if I head towards the sun, we have to remember this. There's a freaking crate here. So someone's been here before. What about this? Are there planks here? Did this used to be a huge... What is this made of? I can't tell if that's wood. I guess it might be wood. Was it like a firewatch tower or something? This is a really good milestone to remember. So there's a tower to the north. Okay, a tower to the north. Oh. Is this a fire? Search. Someone else has been here. Bolts and rope. Holy crap. And there's probably nothing else here, right? Oh, we can grab these things. Oh, that's fantastic. No space in inventory. No. Wait. We'll eat some chanterelles. Or what do we only have one of? Cooked. Sure, we'll eat some hoof fungus. Yeah, we'll eat it. Or did we not do it? Cannot be eaten raw. Screw it. There we go. We're eating our valuable chanterelle so we can get this piece of rope. We should probably head back then. That would be such a bummer if we found some really, really crazy stuff. So, as you can see in the upper right-hand corner of the lockpick required. Oh my god. Oh my god. Steel wire? No! And we need an axe. Wow, there's an entire encampment here. This is fantastic. All this stuff to search. Oh, but planks. Bunnies, there's planks. Oh, there's so many planks. Happy day. Oh my gosh. I was wondering where we'd find planks. Go figure, it's going to be in a place where there were humans before. Wow, we're definitely going to have to come back here and dump off a lot of stuff. Jute rope, steel wire. So much steel wire. Is this the jute rope? Yes, it is. I don't know what a jute rope is. Huh. Bunnies, if any of you know what a jute, you know, J-U-T-E, a jute rope is, could you let me know in the comments? It's so odd. All right, they had a lot of fires. We got a lot of planks. How are we doing here? 7 planks. Not enough, but gosh, we're out. We're out. We better head back. The sun is high. I would love to come back here. This is definitely the first place that we're going after we like drop off our stuff and repair. Let's go ahead and use up all our stamina. We're sprinting. We're like Usain Bolt. Let's get out of here. Oh, no more ruby beats. Wow. We are stacked to the max. Can we restack? That doesn't help. Oh, I could feel it. I could feel it. We're so close to crafting things. We got more sticks. Heck yes. Can you imagine sprinting through the forest? You're just like, let's get everything. God, this game is so chill. I love it. Oh, some moss. We need this, but we can't get it, can we? Because we're full. Okay, this we legit need. Eat a button mushroom. There we go. Grab it. Perfect. We need one more stump moss. Maybe that'll grow back. As silly as that sounds, because it's like, how will it grow back that quickly, right? Okay, we're back. Okay, good, good, good. All right, let's drop some stuff off. Especially the things that we cannot eat. Storage box. Okay, let's see. Beets, can't eat it. Can we move over a stack? There we go. Right click. Can't eat this. Mulberries. How are we? Oh, all right. I guess we'll just move them all. We got the bolts. We got the moss. We got some seeds. Lots of sticks. Planks, which we need. You know what? We're just moving everything. And we'll just grab some berries for later. I'm pretty sure we can eat berries, right? That'll be kind of silly if we couldn't. Yeah, we can eat them. Oh, that's great. Cooked berries. Cooked berries. How does that work? All right, let's go ahead and save. Sun's still up. I don't want to go into day 3 yet. It has moved. So let's go, go, go. I remember we went around the left side at first. Although, it seemed like we found a really safe way to go across the river. We hugged to the right. So let's go ahead and mimic that if we can. I was so excited. Holy crap, our stamina is so low. Yeah, we've been sprinting like nonstop. Oh, hey, little hare. One day, we're going to kill you and skin you. Oh, what was that? Running for too long will burn more energy. The red stamina line indicates when it's time to take a breather. Okay. I heard a click. All right, we're hearing the bees again. This is perfect. That's such a cool way of getting you familiar with an area. Aural cues, visual cues, obviously. So once we're up here, we should cut to the right. Keep an eye out. There's that tower, I guess. I love it. It's organically kind of orienting you. Are these ash leaves? Yes, they are. All right, buddies, let's loot the heck out of this place. Oh, we got some foot fungus. Or hoof. Ew. We got some foot fungus. Oh, no. Oh, my God. All right, let's get ourselves a beat. Sun's going down, so we got to be a little quick. Grab steel wire for sure. It's not something that you're just going to find lying around in the woods other than a human, well, a previously inhabited area. Old rags, bolts, beautiful. Steel wire, beautiful. I know, I saw a recipe where we needed some steel wire, so this is great. She wrote steel wire? Heck yes. Wow, we're making out like bandits. Please be another plank. Oh, it's steel pipe. All right, we got it. All right, what else? This might be it. All that we can do at the moment. At least we haven't really cooked any food yet, and that's probably a good thing because you remember in the difficulty setting they said that there was a bear? Definitely want to store your food outside of the cabin, but I would imagine with this storage box system you'd be storing it in your cabin. That's a little suspect. I don't know if I would do that. Especially until I had some kind of additional fencing, guarding, anything like that. I mean, have you ever seen national parks? They have those bear-proof, kind of, they look like postal boxes for food and trash and things like that. I mean, those things are straight up metal with a giant rotating clamp on the inside. So I don't know if my little like wooden cabin will stop a bear. Oh, our stamina's going down. Or just walk. There's our beautiful cabin. All right, bunnies. This is excellent. So our health is down. Our hunger is a little bit up there. Holy crap, we made out like bandits. Hopefully we'll find another place where humans were. I feel like you kind of want to keep looking upwards, because if you're looking up, then eventually you'll see like the tower as an example. That's unnatural. That's different. So now that we're up, let's go ahead and grab some more food. Let's head out towards the back of the cabin, away from the sun in the morning. And let's see what we can find. My hope is that there are encampments. Oh, planks! Oh, thank baby Jesus. So we're at about 8 planks now. I know we need like 21 for whatever that other recipe was. Maybe we'll find one more stump moss. I see a stump over here, right? Yes! Heck yes, but we need more planks still. We're not even at 12. I know we've got 8 total, including the one in our inventory now. We got a stick here. Oh, and there's another one here. Oh my God, this is so much closer. Oh, this is great. Wow, steel pipes? I gotta say, I'm very, very, very thankful that these humans do not follow the leave no trace principle. Normally, I would say, oh, the nerve of these people leaving all this human stuff all over the place. But boy, in this situation, I am so thankful that they are not following the leave no trace principle. Some nails, our very first nails. Wow. If you ever needed planks, my God. I remember thinking in my head a moment ago, I was like, you know, the stump moss, right? Does that moss come back? Obviously, time probably moves faster in the game world than it does in real life, because that wouldn't be a very good game if that were the case. Let's be real. You'd have to wait like a year in order to get more moss or something. I don't know, however long it takes. But wouldn't it be funny if they're all like, oh, the jute rope and the bolts, they grew back. I don't think that's gonna happen. All right, we got a lot of rope now. We're definitely getting more bolts. We got a lot of steel wire. This is fantastic. Once we zoom on through, I think we've pretty much picked up everything without breaking these things. Gosh, we need an axe. We're gonna get so much stuff. Lockpick required. And probably the final pile, nails and bolts. How many do we have? We have 2 nails, 2 bolts. Unfortunately, that only brings us to 3 bolts. A lot of jute rope, though. Anything else? Am I missing anything? I mean, here's the great thing, though. The fact that we're so close to the cabin means we can just sprint on back, drop this stuff off. Oh, interesting. As well, take a look at the lower right-hand corner. Our health has not gone up. So you remember when our health went down when we were freezing? That's like semi-permanent until you can do something specific, I guess, to bring it back up. That's cool. Let's take a look. Let's take a look around. Driftwood. We need one more driftwood. We can make a cooking room. That's going to be huge. Storage attic. I mean, storage would be nice, but if you... We're going to use up a lot of these supplies making the other things, so that's going to be my last one. Crafting room. This is huge. All right, we're definitely doing this. Yes! Look at that! Do you see the axe? Oh, I'm excited about this. Features unlock craft tools, resources, and objects. Wow! Okay, I want to see this from the outside, actually. It is bigger! That's fantastic! I'm feeling very triumphant now. Let's take a quick look. What do we got? This is a nice room. I would stream out of this room. Absolutely I would if I can get broadband here. So I just want to point out that every once in a while when I click forward, it just kind of keeps moving forward of its own accord. A little bit of a bummer, but let's see. Resources. We can make nails out of steel wire now. Oh no, make steel wire bolts used for construction. You can make bolts out of a pipe. You can make nails out of steel wire. I don't know if I understand that, but okay. Interesting. We got glute, woodsman's axe. Definitely want a woodsman's axe for sure. There's so many crates right now. We are building the heck out of this thing. I don't even have to think of anything else. Heck yes. So now in slot number 2, we now have an axe. You can see it here. Oh, this is great. Definitely going to save. And since the sun's still up, let's go. Although we probably want to drop things off in the storage box here. Is there anything that we can eat? Not really. So we'll just have to keep an eye out. Yeah. All right, let's do it. Here we go. We're going out to the back. This is the closest one to us. Might as well start there. Because let me tell you, if somehow in this world... Ooh, a stick. If somehow in this world... Do you ever see sticks just sticking up like that? Sorry. If somehow in this world those crates come back and respawn somehow, you know, grow over time, then, you know, I'd rather them be the ones that are... We'll start on the ones closest to us, you know? There it is. There it is. We're here. Oh my gosh, this is exciting. All right, so we can now open crates, I assume. Woodsman's axe. Oh, we could probably chop down trees too. That's going to be huge for us. Let's do it. Oh! Holy God, that was explosive. God, one swing. We're strong, despite our health going down. All right, let's do it. Jesus, that is... That's really loud. Just absolute death from above. Here we go. Jute rope. Not as much as I thought. As far as things would be in there, I would totally try and smash this, but apparently we need a lockpick. Oh, we can probably make a lockpick though. We've got a lot of metal-based items, right? All right, so I guess that was it. Oh, that's a little disappointing. Can we chop down these trees at all? God, look at how strong we are. Can I push it? Do I have to keep hitting it? Oh, there we go. There we go. And they make planks and sticks. That's great. We're going to need to do this a lot. Oh my gosh. So definitely we made the right choice in creating the crafting room first. Oh, let's take a look. We do need to eat something, so we got to keep an eye out. Or maybe make a fire. Oh, we need a fire quickly so we can start to eat some of those other mushrooms that we found, right? Keep an eye out. We need to eat things. Oh, boy. If we starve, we're going to be in trouble. Okay, we are starving now. Crap. All right, go, go, go. Hopefully, we'll have everything that we need to build a fire. How would we make fire, though? Do we have flint stone or anything? Come on. A little dire right now. Not fire, fire, fire. Oh, we can't build a fire. What? You don't even tell us? So let's see. Med kit. Okay, old rags. Da 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 da. Health. Med kit. Tools. A map. A compass is amazing. That would be great. Nails. Map. Can't do fire. Why? I wish they would tell us why. Interesting. Okay, well, we've we've got a bit of an emergency right now. Storage box. Beets. I'm pretty sure we cannot eat them raw. Mushrooms, chance to be poisoned. Oh, God. We don't have a choice. Okay, let's see. Ruby beets cannot be eaten raw. Ash leaves, can't eat those raw. Buddies, cross your fingers. Yes! All right, we live a little bit longer. We better get the heck out of here and start just dumping. We need food pronto. That's going to be probably the, looking at the time, probably the last thing that we do on this episode. But buddies, I gotta say, I'm really enjoying this. I don't know about you. Let me know in the comments what you think. If this is something that you want to keep seeing, we'll probably do one more of this. But and then just let me know what you guys think. If you like this, I would love to keep playing this, even though it's only in early access and everything. It feels so polished already. I mean, look at this light. I mean, come on. That's beautiful. Oh, Chanterelle. Oh, loveliest name in the English language. Chanterelle. Le Chanton. Le Button Mushroom. Please don't kill me, France. All right. Anything else? More ash leaves. What do you do with the leaves? You like put them together and make like a paper mache type substance, turn them into glue, use the fibers. I don't know, strip them leaves and turn them into something. Oh, we got berries. And how do you actually unlock the fire? You know what I mean? And do we ever get bows and arrows so we can, you know, I'm sorry to say, like hurt some hairs? Or don't get so caught up that you have to split hairs. Yeah, that's right. Well, you know, buddies, we've got a little bit of food. We can at least eat this. Gosh, that doesn't help too much. Mushrooms. Sun's still up. So, I know, there's the waterfall, right? You know what? Do you remember we heard the bees, right? Although, they could probably hurt us. I was going to say, oh, more driftwood. Oh, makes sense, near the water. Definitely need two more of these. There's one here, and I think there was one here, right? Yeah, excellent. And what happens if you have to venture out farther and farther to get food? Do you know what I mean? Like, is there a tent or a bedroll or anything? Because you'd be in serious trouble if you have to go back to the cabin every single time, right? It'll just get worse and worse and worse, because you start to consume everything around you, and eventually you have to go out deeper radiuses. Is there a cave? There's a cave. What's in the cave? Hopefully it's not a bear. Oh. Oh, wow. Holy crap. Well, buddies, I think this is a really, really good place to stop. I thoroughly enjoyed this game. I know that survival genre games are not really my cup of tea, but I gotta say, I really, really, really liked Among Trees. So, buddies, let me know what you think in the comments below if you like it. We can definitely keep going with it, even though it's only in early access. I do want to remind everyone that this is in pre-alpha, so this is very, very early on. Things could absolutely change, but the lighting, the visuals, the peaceful, meditative qualities to it, it feels very polished already. I'm really excited about it. So thank you so much for joining me. I had a total blast. I hope you did as well, and I can't wait to get back into it with you. I'll catch you on the next one. Have a good night.